How much do mouse polling rates affect performance in a CPU intensive game? Now, normally this channel is all about Star Citizen, but to be fair, this video will be relevant if you are, I guess, into competitive shooters, but also maybe into aim training. I've gone down a massive rabbit hole here. There's all sorts of random stuff. And so we've got three systems that I've done a load of testing on. So we've got a 9800 HDD system with a 5080. That's very high end. We've got a kind of more mid-range system, a 5800 HDD with a 3080. And then we've got, for Star Citizen, kind of the minimum that I'd recommend, a i5 10400 system with 16 gigabytes of RAM and a GTX 1660. I've done a load of testing in Star Citizen at 1000, 2000, 4000 and 8000 hertz for the polling rate, and we'll show you what the impact is, because yeah, depending on what you're using, and if you've got yourself a really fancy mouse, really light with this crazy polling rate, you'll need to take care. This journey began for me when my old mouse started to double click unintentionally, and so I needed to buy something new. I decided, even though I'm not a competitive player in any sense, I thought, well, maybe I'll just get myself a good mouse. And to be fair, I do some video editing as well, and that has been much easier with a lighter mouse. And that's the main thing that, for me, that has been really useful. But I've got myself this, the Viper V3 Pro, pretty high-end mouse. And before we get into the actual testing, I'm just going to try and explain this whole thing, mouse polling, and how it affects CPU usage, and we'll show you a few different things that I've done. So first of all, here is, like I said, I went down a big rabbit hole, some aim trainer stuff. So as I looked into all this stuff, one of the big thing when it comes to competitive play and high-end mice and all that sort of stuff is using aim trainers to improve your aim. And it's quite useful to actually show some of this stuff. So first of all here, at the top, we've got 125 hertz, very low. And below we've got 1000 hertz. And this is really just to demonstrate what we're talking about. So the idea behind mouse polling rates is the amount of updates per second you're getting. And so in theory, the more updates, the smoother the performance, the feel of it will be for you when you're playing in game. And if you look at the top with the 125 hertz polling rate, you should be able to see kind of more judderiness. In theory, below, and I think I can see it with my eyes, everything is much smoother. So that's just to kind of highlight what we're looking at. In theory, the higher the polling rate, especially when you're using really high refresh rate monitors, you have smoother performance. And for these people who are chasing either scores on aim trainers or trying to be really high ranked on these competitive games, the more precise you can be, the better. But for Star Citizen, obviously none of that really is particularly relevant. But this just shows you kind of what we're looking at, the smoothness that we're kind of chasing after. Next up, we're going to use a little utility that is provided by Razer to measure your polling rate, and it shows quite an interesting thing. So first of all, we're starting here with 1000 hertz, and you see as I move the mouse around in circles, in theory we can max out at 1000 updates per second. We then go into the software and we change the polling rate to 2000, and so now as we move around in our circle, the amount of updates per second is now gone. It should max out at 2000. It doesn't always hit that. If you're not moving your mouse, like you can see, it will slow right down. So it is really linked to actually what you're doing with your mouse. It's the same with 4000. It's not too tricky with these circles I'm making here to hit, basically cap out the 4000 hertz rate. But at 8K, it's actually pretty difficult at this DPI to get to 8K. You have to really make really exaggerated movements. And it's pretty difficult to get to 8,000 updates per second, as you can see. So as we go through this and as we get towards the testing at the end, have in your mind that with the 8K rate, you're not kind of saturating that all the time. It's only in certain moments when you might even go above the 4,000 mark. So it isn't just that when you change your polling rate, then you're just completely pushing your CPU at all points. It would only be when you're doing really exaggerated movements. Next up, we're going to look at CPU usage in Task Manager as I make those same movements. So at 1000 hertz, as I make those circles, you can see the Task Manager kind of reading for utilization of the CPU goes up. As I stop, it settles down again. At 2000, well, as you'd expect, we're now pushing the CPU a little bit more. Roughly, I think if you look down there, about kind of 11, 10%. in total. Then 4,000, and again, make the circles. We are then peaking more at 16%. It's not insignificant amounts of CPU. It's a powerful CPU we're using. And then at 8K, again, remember, we're not probably able to saturate the full 8K update rate, but we are still seeing even more usage. And so hopefully this just highlights as a start that this is a thing. Like, the polling rate does affect the amount of CPU cycles and everything that's going on. And so there's an argument to say that nobody probably would ever even notice maybe 8K anyway, and even 4K is really questionable, and especially if you're not on a really high-end refresh rate monitor. But probably quite a lot of this stuff is not that well known. It'd be quite easy to buy one of these fancy mice and then say, well, the advertising is all 8K hertz, and just stick that as your setting and then not realize that it might actually be affecting your in-game performance. Next up, we're back into the AIM trainer, and you're gonna have to excuse the fact that I'm useless at this. This is not good. But you can see at the top, the GPU usage, even when we're at 940 odd FPS, is still only 74%. So we are on the CPU mainly here. And so as I move around, you can see that it does kind of drop at various points as I guess push the update. But again, we're only at 1,000 hertz here for the polling rate. So we're between, well, I don't know. But as I spin, again, putting more pressure maybe on the mouse, you can see that the number really does drop quite considerably. But as I then switch over to 8K, in general play here, as I'm just trying to shoot these targets, well, I think it's a bit lower. There is a drop. We are already seeing, just with these smaller movements, a kind of less FPS, I think, than we were at 1,000, as we kind of would expect from that task manager test. And then as I go crazy and spin, we're really dropping. And as I exaggerate those spins, sorry if you're sick, down to the 600 FPS, which obviously is loads. But again, it just highlights that there are scenarios. I guess if you're, I don't know, there are, I think there's a 700 hertz monitor that's maybe coming out or has just been released. And so there potentially are some very unique scenarios where your FPS might genuinely affect. I don't know. I don't know if anybody ever can feel the difference between 900 FPS and 600, but who knows? That's obviously not what I'm that interested in here. Let's move on to the actual testing in Star Citizen. We're going to stick with my normal Lawville run, running around the city in Lawville. If you don't know Star Citizen, it's very heavy on the CPU. It's quite unoptimized. It's very ambitious as a game. The engine really in the cities really pushes your computer. So in Lawville, with the 9800 XGD system, you can see that, well, at 8K, there is a little bit of a potential drop. Not that you'd probably ever notice. This is probably within the kind of margin of error territory, but there's a hint that 8K polling, and again, like we said before, there'll be moments where you're not pushing it that hard, but if there's more exaggerated movements around this kind of run that I'm doing here, you would see potentially your polling rate go up. And so not much to be worried about potentially in Star Citizen at 8K if you've got a really high-end system. What about the mid-range system? So there is more of a hit here. Again, it's pretty small, but the pattern is kind of the same. The rest of them are basically the same, but at 8K there is a probably unperceivable drop. But as we now look at the low-end system, it kind of all confirms what we're seeing. None of these frame rates are good on the minimum spec system that I've got here, but the 8K one is significantly down on the others. I mean, yeah, you wouldn't want to play many games at 23 FPS anyway, but 17 definitely is worse. And when I show you the frame time graph, you will be able to tell what's going on here. There, at 8K on the mouse, significant spikes. Some, I think one there is reaching 7,000 milliseconds, so 7 seconds. And so the system, it was awful to try and do this testing, running around Lawville many, many times to try and get good data. But on this setup with the 8K polling rate on the mouse, it was awful, like genuinely awful. Very big stutters, long stutters, really hard to play, and it was completely unusable. More unusable than you might think just looking at the numbers on the graph. When you see the frame time graph, you can see that it's not great. And to be fair, even on the 1K one at the top there, there's still some big spikes, but that is just starcism, really. So what do we do with all this? Effectively, if you're on a high-end system, you probably don't need to worry too much about it in a game like Star Citizen. If you were playing some sort of lighter game, competitive game, where you were trying to really make sure you hit a real high target frame rate, you wouldn't probably want to take the risk. And also, the point again is that it's pretty well accepted that 4K, 8K, there's not much benefit. Like, it's almost completely unnoticeable, the difference. And so why it's on the kind of mouse advertising, why it's been pushed so high as like a feature, I don't know. But for a low-end system, and if you're playing a really intensive game like Star Citizen that's already really pushing your CPU, you don't want to go anywhere near higher mouse polling. That's probably the big takeaway. For Star Citizen itself, stick to a 1,000, I think, probably. I mean, 2,000 maybe you might feel it if you've got a high refresh rate monitor, but even then, you're not going to have much use for a high refresh rate monitor in Star Citizen anyway. And so for Star Citizen itself, don't buy a really high-end mouse for high polling rates, because all you'll do is push your CPU even more than it already was being pushed before. So there we go.